What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to upload workshop maps on a Project Zomboid server. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. In the zombie-infested world of Project Zomboid, there are actually a lot of locations to play and attempt to survive in. But after some time, you might want to try other maps to try and expand your gameplay and options. Luckily, the Steam Workshop gives you access to a ton of player-created maps, which can give you entirely new designs or even variations of different locations. With Apex, you can do all of this in your game panel, so let's go over how to get started. First, head in to the Project Zomboid Workshop page and find the map that you want to use in your game. Once you're on the maps page, press the green subscribe button and then launch Project Zomboid at least once to make sure the mod's fully installed. Next, from the Steam Project Zomboid page, press the gear icon on the right and then go to Manage and browse local files until a folder opens. In the folder path at the top, click Steam Apps, and then go to Workshop, Content, and then 108600. From here, find and open the folder with the correct mod ID, and then afterwards go to Mods, your map's name, and then Media. Make a note of any of the folders located here because we will need those in just a minute. Head to the Apex server panel and stop the server. In the left-hand menu, enter the FTP file access, log in, and then enter the media folder. Press upload in the top left, and then drag and drop the folders from earlier. And once they are 100% loaded, you can head back to the main panel page. Now that the files are properly uploaded to the server, you'll need to configure the game to make sure it loads up normally. From the Apex panel, enter the config files on the left-hand side, and then open the spawn regions file. On a new line, you'll have to type in this sequence, making sure to replace both accounts of map name with the one that you found earlier. When you're done, press save, but don't restart the server just yet. Back in config files, open the world config file, and then find the mods field and enter the mod ID from the workshop page. Under the map field, enter this sequence, replacing your map name with the folder name from earlier. Finally, under workshop items, paste the mod's number ID from the workshop page. Press save at the bottom of the page, and then you can restart the server. With that, you now know how to download, prepare, and install a Project Zomboid workshop map. This process can be a bit confusing due to all of the changes that you have to make, but once it is fully configured, you should be all good to go. There are a ton of maps to choose from, whether it's to improve existing locations and buildings or to create a completely new area. If you ever want to remove the map, simply just reverse the steps that you followed and make sure to clear out all of the config files and you're as good as new. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.